Assalamu alaikum students, in today's lecture we are going to prove a theorem which is called Cauchy's general principle for convergence. Cauchy's general principle for convergence. So this is also called Cauchy criterion for the convergence of a sequence. So this states that a sequence of real numbers is convergent if and only if it is a Cauchy sequence. Okay, so this theorem is a biconditional theorem. Okay, so first of all, we will suppose a convergent sequence and we will show that it is a Cauchy sequence. And then we will conversely prove this theorem by supposing a Cauchy sequence and showing that it is a convergent sequence. So let us start with the proof. So first we suppose that a sequence Sn is a convergent sequence and we will prove that it is a Cauchy sequence. So since Sn is a convergent sequence, so for a positive real number epsilon there exists a positive integer n naught such that Sn minus S mod is less than epsilon by 2 for all n greater than n naught. Okay, so here we take S as the limit of our convergent sequence Sn. So we show that Sn is a Cauchy sequence. So now for the numbers n which is greater than m and which is greater than n naught, Sn minus Sm. So we have to basically show that this thing is less than epsilon. So Sn minus Sm can be written as Sn minus S plus S minus Sm mod. Okay, so this thing can be further written as Sn minus Sm mod, so which is equal to Sn minus S and minus Sm minus S whole mod. Okay, so this thing can be written as, so this thing implies for all n greater than m greater than n naught. So this thing can be written as Sn minus Sm mod is less than or equal to Sn minus S mod plus Sm minus S mod from triangular inequality. Okay, and if we plug in the values of Sn minus S and Sm minus S from here, so this thing implies Sn minus Sm mod is less than epsilon over 2 plus here again epsilon over 2. So this thing implies Sn minus Sm mod is less than epsilon. So this implies Sn is a Cauchy sequence. Okay, so here we supposed that Sn is a convergent sequence and we prove that it is a Cauchy sequence. So now we will do this thing again conversely. Now we will suppose that our sequence is a Cauchy sequence and we will show that it is convergent. Okay, so let Sn be a Cauchy sequence so then by the definition of a Cauchy sequence, so Sn minus Sm mod is less than epsilon over 2 for all n m greater than n naught, for some positive integer n naught. So here Sn is a Cauchy sequence. So using a theorem that we studied in the last lecture, that every Cauchy sequence has a convergent subsequence. Okay, so Sn is a Cauchy sequence, so it will have a subsequence that will be convergent. Okay, so Sn has a convergent subsequence. Okay, so let Snk be the subsequence of Sn. So let Snk be that subsequence. So here Snk is a convergent subsequence. So Snk converges. So let us suppose Snk converges to some limit S. Okay, so for epsilon positive, there exists a positive integer suppose n1 such that Snk minus S mod is less than epsilon over 2 for all n greater than n1. Okay, so now Sn minus S mod can be written as Sn minus Snk plus Snk minus S mod. Okay, so Sn minus S mod is less than or equal to Sn minus Snk mod plus Snk minus S mod from triangular inequality. So Sn minus S mod is less than, now Sn minus Snk, so this thing is from here, this thing is less than epsilon over 2 and plus Snk minus S is again less than epsilon over 2. So Sn minus S mod is less than epsilon. Okay, so this thing implies that Sn is convergent. So it converges to S. So we suppose that Sn is a Cauchy sequence and we proved that Sn is convergent. Okay, so a sequence of real numbers is convergent if and only if it is a Cauchy sequence. Okay, so first we supposed that Sn is a convergent sequence and we proved that it is a Cauchy sequence, and then we conversely suppose that Sn is a Cauchy sequence and we prove that it is convergent. So this theorem is known as Cauchy's general principle for convergence. It is also called Cauchy's criterion for the convergence of a sequence.